I'm in Wyoming to celebrate the next nuclear breakthrough, Microsoft co-founder Bill Gates said in his blog while he was busy visiting a historic new power plant site funded by him. Smaller, cheaper, safer? Can it justify the breakthrough in new nuclear plant technology? Before we rush to a conclusion, let's look at what Bill Gates says about the future of nuclear energy. Nuclear energy, if we do it right, will help us solve our climate goals, Gates told ABC News. That is, eliminate the greenhouse gas emissions without making the electricity system far more expensive or less reliable. The billionaire had invested in TerraPower, one company that wants to build mini nuclear power plants. And they are planning to open a new plant in Kemmerer, Wyoming. The company hopes to revolutionize the nuclear energy industry in the U.S. to help them fight climate change and support American energy independence. By 2030, the power plant should be ready for operation. That's what Gates says. At that point, he expects it to be the most advanced nuclear facility in the world. The Natrium plant. Doesn't it sound so cool? Gates is all thrilled and excited, and he is all the way more convinced that the facility will be a win for the local economy. Furthermore, what makes it more interesting? It's the latest sodium technology that is being used. Gates claims it produces less nuclear waste and also emphasizes its safety. You might be wondering how he is so sure about it. According to Gates, the design has been tested several times using supercomputers, and that too under every imaginable catastrophe scenario. And the power plant has withstood anything and everything that came along its way. Does all this matter? Yes, the world needs to make a big bet on nuclear. That's the answer Gates has to offer. In his book, How to Avoid Climate Disaster, he has written, "We need nuclear power if we're going to meet the world's growing need for energy while also eliminating carbon emissions." He further adds on the problems related to nuclear. Gates mentions that the plants are expensive to build and the slightest human error can cause accidents. Moreover, there are chances that the communities and workers providing reliable energy for decades will be left behind. So basically, to solve all these problems, they came up with the Natrium facility. Starting with the improved safety it offers, let me remind you of one thing. America's current fleet of nuclear plants has been operating safely for decades, and in terms of lost lives, nuclear power is the safest way to produce energy. Guess what? The upcoming facility in Kemmerer will be even better. Aren't you curious to know about its functioning? Like any other power plant design, it majorly uses heat to turn water into steam, which moves a turbine and generates electricity. So how does the heat get generated? In a chain reaction, the uranium atoms split, generating heat. That's pretty much like other nuclear facilities. Wait, let's put a full stop to the similarities and move forward to what makes it different. The power plant will be cooled with liquid sodium rather than traditionally using water. What are the challenges posed while using water as a coolant? The first one is that water isn't very good at absorbing heat. At just 100 degrees Celsius, water stops absorbing heat and turns into steam. On the other hand, liquid sodium has a higher boiling point, and to add on, it doesn't need to be pumped. So even in cases of power failures, the cooling continues. Let's say there's a sudden earthquake that cuts off all the electricity to the plant. What will happen if you can't keep on pumping water? Ultimately, the core gets heated up, raising the pressure, and boom! It would result in an explosion. So Natrium plant using liquid sodium is a win-win. The new plant, which has been in the works for the past 15 years, doesn't only stand out in terms of safety. There's more to the story. The Natrium design also includes an energy storage system. What does it do? It controls how much electricity it produces at any given time. That sounds unique among nuclear reactors. Moreover, it's essential while integrating with power grids that use variable sources like solar and wind. The power plant will have an output of 345 megawatts. Further, during peak times, it can be increased to up to 500 megawatts. According to earlier information from TerraPower, the power plant will cost around $1 billion. Another thing that's different in TerraPower is its digital design process. As we mentioned in the beginning, using supercomputers, they've digitally tested the Natrium design countless times, simulating every imaginable disaster. And it keeps holding up. What sophisticated work! This has drawn interest from around the globe, including an agreement to collaborate on nuclear power technology in Japan and investments from the South Korean conglomerate SK and the multinational steel company ArcelorMittal. The residents of Kemmerer are quite friendly and have a special interest in the facility's success because the nearby coal plant that has been in operation for more than 50 years is set to close. The 110 or more workers there would be unemployed if the Natrium facility wasn't there. However, they will be able to find work in the Natrium plant. Around 200 to 250 people will be employed by the new plant, and individuals with prior experience working in a coal plant will be able to perform most of the jobs with little to no further training. This ranges from running a turbine and maintaining links to the electricity grid. Are you excited about this project because of what it holds for the future? Stay tuned for more exciting innovations.